So here we are with the 11th and, for the time being, last episode of the first series of Controlix Developer. To celebrate not only Christmas, but also our big final, we have all of our experts from the previous sessions with us. And of course, we have something new for today, which will be presented once again by Johannes.
Yeah, it's great to be here again. And for sure, it's good to have most of our experts with me, because this way you don't have to talk too much today, Christian. That's why I asked Holger to join us directly from the beginning. But seriously, I want to make a short follow-up of our last episode about Python. And by the way, you have still the chance to win one of these t-shirts. Watch our last episode, give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment, and you take part in the draw. Anyway, now I will show you how easy you can program your machine during runtime.
But weren't all episodes follow-ups, Holger?
I just wanted to say that, in my opinion, we've gone deeper and deeper inside the system, beginning from the project in the front end to the tools and the security mechanisms, to the programming and the various possibilities we have on project side.
And of course, also about the community.
Sure. I didn't mean to skip the episode with Pedro, where he showed us everything about the Controlix automation community. With this community, we support our users to get help and exchange information in a very easy and efficient way.
And then we have a separate episode about the most mentioned topic, security.
Yes, that was a very good and important episode. We created an open and modular automation platform, and security was always in the focus.
Yes, we have actually connected impossible things with it, right?
Totally. Also in regard to the Controlix device portal. It's such an invaluable advantage to maintain all your machines remotely, and also to do software updates and a backup and restore of a device in a completely secure and remote way.
By the way, we have already talked about all these topics and demonstrated them using various application examples. The corresponding videos on security, programming and the community and many others can be found in our playlist and linked below.
Well done, Johannes. I think you can take my job when I just retire.
Well, I've listened to you enough times now. But let me do this right now. How about Kai comes up here? Hi Kai, nice to have you here. What was the topic of the second episode again?
Hi Johannes. Well, I had the pleasure of demonstrating how easy and user-friendly the Controlix core can be connected and operated.
Exactly. But what would you say to someone who is currently working with a proprietary system and who is currently still comfortable with it?
I would say Controlix automation is much faster and easier. It's not just about simplicity. I mean, simplicity is a feature.
And you did a real unboxing and showed how easy it is to bring the Controlix core into operation?
Yes, there are so many ways to use a Controlix core and set up your own project. So if you're coming from PLC programming, you can still use PLC programming environments. And otherwise, there are modern programming languages supported. Above all, Controlix automation opens up completely new areas of application.
That is for areas that were not possible with our previous hardware and software.
That's correct. I will show you now how we can take it one step further. As I indicated earlier, we simply make it easier to program on Controlix Core during runtime. And we make it very easy to provide machine operators with necessary building blocks to make changes to your code very quickly.
This was also part of our vision, maximum simplicity and usability.
And this is why we turned graphical programming into a separate application to make changes to your code as easy as possible in ongoing production, for example.
And the programming language the whole thing is based on is Python?
The whole thing is based on Google Blockly and creates Python scripts, for example. And as I mentioned in the episode before, I will show it to you now. As we all know, Holger is not programming that often anymore. For this, I log into my Controlix core and I have the app pre-installed. I have now logged in into my Controlix core and here I can open the graphical editor. And now we can create a new project. Here the new project is created and it's actually empty and now we can start right away.
So with a graphical user interface, even I could program?
Of course. And for those who don't know Google Blockly, it works simply on graphical code blocks.
You just drag and drop the blocks you need from the respective directory.
Exactly. And this way, I can also move axes. Let's move the axes to two different positions. For example, from 0 to 100. And with Google Blockly, you can see from the shape of the block if they fit together.
And so I can program a complete pick and place application with these blocks, for example, or access the data from the data layer.
This can also be done on an HMI, an interface directly on the machine. The machine operator only needs rudimentary programming knowledge to move an axis to a different position, simply by drag and drop this code block.
And we have programmed these building blocks and they are available for everybody.
We provide the important building blocks here, for example, to move an axis. And the advantage of our editor is that we can switch between our code blocks and the underlying Python.
Meaning you can start programming graphically here, and if something doesn't work, you can switch back to the Python code.
Or just add something if there's no block available for your application. The whole thing works completely bidirectionally. In the graphical view, you can see all the blocks which already exist. Mm. And in the Python view, you can see the complete code. And on the ControlX core, the code is interpreted, by the way, completely automatically.
Cool for applications during runtime. One question that will be of particular interest for our users. Is it possible to program own code blocks?
Sure, you can program own code blocks and put them into the graphical editor.
If a customer brings these code blocks to the editor, he can make it easily available for the machine operator.
It was important to us that the whole thing has no restrictions.
But what can I put in such a block? A string, a function, a movement?
Even there, you have all the freedom you need. At some point, the whole thing becomes, of course, as with all graphical programming, simply confusing. For example, a block fits best for an axis movement, and the speed values can be defined afterwards. But you know what? Let me just program a little machine, and maybe Pedro can join us for this session. So now I start to add a few blocks to make a machine draw a Christmas tree, because it's Christmas. We already prepared a configuration of a kinematic.
Cool, and what a coincidence. We also have the right machine set up for that.
Ah, hi Pedro, nice to have you here. Let's start. Now I start the execution of these code blocks. And if I want to change something now, I can do that during runtime. As explained in the last episode, simply by changing the corresponding lines of code or changing the code blocks. Now I want to change our Christmas tree to the House of Santa. Let's start the program by executing the changed code blocks.
By the way, the whole thing is completely integrated and web-based. That means you do not need an additional installation on a separate device. You only have to install the graphical programming app on the ControlX core.
Wow, that sounds great. Probably not so many people in the automation industry are using Blockly.
No, definitely not.
Sorry, but I have a question. How did you get this idea? In an environment where others use PLC programming, how did you rely on such a graphical solution?
Since we have our open and modular automation platforms, this is naturally possible, unlike proprietary systems. And therefore, we have the opportunity to make operations in the processes and in production much easier, even for machine operators. And developers in the companies can practically create code construction kits for production processes. And therefore, we are talking about a completely different league.
Two steps ahead.
And why, of all things, Google Blockly as a basis?
Blockly is simply the only software that makes sense in these areas and meets our requirements. Elsewhere, we're working with Node-RED, which is also a great graphical interface, but works more with flows. For the solutions we have in mind, Blockly was the best basis. Can you confirm that, Christian?
Well, what can I say? I know the good old PLC systems, and this is more than impressive. Thank you, Johannes. Your Christmas tree looks almost as beautiful as the one we have here. And also, thank you for being with me for most of the shows. That's it for our Christmas show, and also it's the last developer show for 2020. So Kai, please come back on stage with us. Thank you to everybody who made this series possible, and also thank you for all the exciting discussions we had. I really learned a lot about ControlX automation, and most importantly, it was a lot of fun.
And of course, many thanks to you for your interest. So that's it for now. If you don't know all the episodes yet, just look in the playlist or in the description below. And if you already know them all, just watch them again.
And don't forget, come to our forum and become part of the ControlX automation community, where the experts talk has no end.
And ask our developers a lot of questions about the REST APIs, the ControlX data layer, the SDK, and the partner apps, and all the other topics we discussed here.
Sure. And be curious, because season number 2 will be here faster than you think. We'll see you again next spring for sure.
In any case, there are enough topics.
Merry Christmas from all of us and Happy New Year to you. Stay safe and healthy, and we'll catch you on the next one to be 2 steps ahead.